It's always an adventure, arriving somewhere you've never been and making landfall for the very first time.
On this area is slippery. All in the park is very slippery. One by one.
You never know exactly what you're going to see. Even though you might have a good idea of what to expect, there's no guarantees about anything. So it's always a delight to find what you were looking for. We're in the eastern Pacific, right on the equator, on the volcanic shore of the island of Fernandina in the Galapagos, one of the most famous archipelagos in the world. This is the only place where you'll find these marine iguanas, so perfectly camouflaged. The lizards are vegetarians. They mostly eat marine algae. That's why they swim in the ocean. When they're not sunbaking. The Galapagos Islands are around 1,400 kilometres from Ecuador's mainland, or about 2 hours flying time. There are small airports on two different islands, used by most of the 150,000 tourists who visit each year. We arrived at Baltra Airport. You have to catch a ferry to get to the nearby island of Santa Cruz, which is the main population centre. Only 25,000 people live in the Galapagos, and around half of them live in the town of Puerto Ayora. We sailed overnight to Puerto Villamil on Isabela Island. Next morning, we had our first encounters with marine iguanas. They completely ignored us. Just like the sea lion we found on the jetty. Or the one on a nearby park bench. Just inland from Puerto Villamil is the Sierra Negra. This is an active volcano with a massive caldera, 7 to 9 kilometers in diameter. It's an amazing view, a reminder of the awesome geologic power below our feet. This volcano erupted again in 2018. Not far from the volcano, something we did not expect. These flamingos are not African, they're American. Of the 6 different species of flamingos, the ones in the Galapagos are the pinkest. But of all the creatures on the Galapagos, perhaps the giant tortoise is the most iconic. These giants can weigh over 400 kilograms and live for 170 years or more. But by the late 1950s, 4 species were extinct, and all of those remaining were either endangered or on the brink of extinction. Captive breeding programs have helped to bring the populations back, but poachers are still killing these animals in the wild. The main difference between a tortoise and a turtle is that tortoises are land animals. They have short, sturdy feet and bent legs, and a more dome-like shell. Whereas turtles are swimmers with flipper-like legs and webbed feet and a much flatter and more streamlined shell. They can dive for 4 or 5 minutes and only need to surface for a few seconds to catch a breath. It's quite a thrill to swim with them in the wild.
Smiling to me. telling the penguins to hurry up. Yeah,
Was that fun or what?
Oh, that was so good.
West of the Sierra Negra, at Moreno Point, you can see life slowly returning to a lava field. This lava is from a relatively recent eruption, perhaps a few hundred years ago. Yet even now, it is still mostly just a desert of hard stone baking under the tropical sun. But you can see nature at work. Hardy plants are beginning to colonize the area. In a few places, the rain has pulled in depressions, creating small lagoons, which soon attract bird life. At the shoreline, there are plenty of spots for seabirds to nest, including the blue-footed booby, another icon of the Galapagos, which is one of their favourite breeding grounds. The bluer their feet, the healthier the bird. The Galapagos penguin is the only penguin that lives above the equator. These birds seem untroubled by visits from the strange creatures in the orange vests. The flightless cormorant is the largest cormorant in the world, and the only one unable to fly. Its wings have devolved to the point where they are too small for flight. Of course, mangroves are quick to colonise any estuary, a perfect breeding habitat for fish and green turtles. The westernmost island in the Galapagos is Fernandina. It's the youngest and most volcanically active of all the islands. It's less than a million years old. It sits on top of the hotspot that created all of the Galapagos Islands. These are sea lions. The difference between a sea lion and a seal is, firstly, sea lions are really noisy and they bark. Secondly, sea lions can walk on their back flippers, which makes them more mobile on land. Thirdly, sea lions have little ears, although it's a bit hard to see this one. Although the Galapagos are on the equator, the water here can be surprisingly cold. That's why the wetsuits.
There we go. It's alright.
It's good. Actually, there's a bit of a current here.
It's to do with the Humboldt Current, which brings cold water all the way from Antarctica to the equator, especially at certain times of the year. Even so, plenty of the marine life looks tropical. Opposite Fernandina is Tagus Cove. It's a sheltered anchorage that's been popular with sailors ever since it was discovered. When Charles Darwin visited here in 1835, it was because his ship was looking for fresh meat. Nowadays, the local wildlife has little to fear from human visitors. The crater lake above has been named Darwin Lake. It's full of salt water. Of course, there are many pleasures on a Galapagos cruise that have nothing to do with wildlife. But the wildlife is everywhere and always interesting. Highlight for us was our very last swim, when a sea lion decided to play with us. It's hard not to love sea lions.
Lindsay got it. I think she got it. Is that still throw it?
And there was one more waiting for us on the boat when it was time for us to say goodbye. We loved our time in the